everyone, and welcome back to XGate Dental. I'm Emmanuel Kadosh, and we are here to discuss new procedures in the field of dentistry. We will provide interesting new cases to exhibit how doctors use our products to solve complicated dental cases. Don't forget to subscribe and follow to stay up to date, and let's get started. Today we have a case where a patient came to us with a complaint about pain around tooth number 13, and the patient has two upper bridges with different morphology and different colors, but the case itself is in the replacement of the canine and the proper extraction, the placement of the implants inside the tooth, and then the restoration itself. So in this case, when we have a problem with a tooth and we want to extract the tooth and place an implant inside instead of the tooth, we need to have a proper extraction. Proper extraction means that we extract only the tooth and not the bone that surrounds the tooth. In this case, if you want to place the implant right after the extraction, you need to have as minimally invasive an extraction as possible. So what we do is we extract the tooth in tiny little pieces. So the socket itself won't be harmed and will be as small as possible. You don't want to enlarge the socket when you move the tooth. So we extract the tooth. Instead of this tooth, we place an implant. When you're placing the implant, you want the socket to be as small as possible, and you want to have as big as possible torque that can be for this implant, because the bigger the torque, the bigger the primary stability of the implant. The two other implants were placed. At this little tooth, the bridge had quite a long span. You can see that she had a bridge from the canine to maybe tooth number 17. So she had a 3-unit pontics. In this case, we placed the implants, and because of the aesthetical issue, you don't have any other option than to have immediate loading here. You can't send the patient home with such an aesthetical flaw. So on top of the implants, we placed the multi-units, and then right now, what we'll do is we'll take impressions from the multi-unit. Into the multi-units, we attach the skin abutments, and you can see that the height of the skin abutment is much bigger than the height of the tooth that is going to be on the crowns. The teeth themselves are very small because she grinds her teeth. So we place 3 skin abutments, we scan those 3 skin abutments, and then right now we're going to mill the temporary bridge. For the time being, the scan process and the assembly of the bridge, we placed healing caps, and right after the bridge was done, it takes about a day or 2 days. You have the bridge, you assemble the bridge on top of the multi-units, and you can see here the bridge, the teeth themselves are very small. The proportion between the height of the tooth and the width of the tooth is very problematic. We used a regular 4-millimeter sleeve, and with the 4-millimeter sleeve, we can have a small screw channel. In this case, because the teeth themselves are very small, you want to have the smallest screw channel possible that can be, because you want the bridge to be as strong as possible and as much more material as can be. This is the bridge mounted. You can see that all the upper teeth are very, very small. We closed the holes, the screw channel of the teeth, and we made the bridge a little bit smaller because in the upcoming couple of months, it's very problematic for 3 implants to be immediately loaded. We took it out of the occlusion, and we want as little forces as possible to be applied on these implants and on those bridges. We hope that she'll eat on her left side and not on her right, and we took it out of the occlusion also because she's grinding her teeth. When a patient grinds their teeth, a lot of forces are applied on those teeth. So we take out of the occlusion. The healing process will be between 2 to 3 months until the osseointegration process is completed. When the osseointegration process is completed in this case, you can see that we'll keep the straight multi-units. Maybe we'll change the height of one of the multi-units. We still probably want to take impressions again because we want to have a healed gingiva in the impression so we can form the gingival area of the bridge in a proper way. But we are not sure it will go on to change the multi-units themselves. Either way, thank you everyone that joined in. To learn some new and interesting information, make sure to stay tuned for more. And of course, don't forget to subscribe, like, and follow. Thank you, and see you guys next time.